When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness of what threatens to destroy you?
Greetings, everyone. Jay the Filthy Casual coming to you live. So, if you haven't heard, Wizards of the Coast has sold out to Amazon. Now, for some, this is, you know, groundbreaking news. For the rest of us, we kind of figured it was coming. It was only going to be a matter of time. I knew this sort of thing was going to happen. I didn't get the platform right. I had suspected that basically Wizards of the Coast was going to move away from LGS's and move into either their own storefront and or online sales. I think I specifically had stated EB Games. But anyone who's ever gone to EB Games knows the platform or the store themselves are too small, so it never would have worked. I did hypothesize that it would move into an online thing. I suspected they would have paired up with someone that's already established, like Channel Fireball and Star City Games, and then move product out, you know, kind of start folding them into the corporate brand. But they went straight to Amazon, so that's pretty crazy. Now, one person who may have had it right, and you don't want to hear it, it's Jeremy Hambley. Now, on September 8th, he did a video of a leak stating that Amazon was going to be going to, or sorry, Wizards of the Coast was going to be going to Amazon. And that was a few weeks ago. So take it for what it is. Whether he has a source or if somebody had sent him an email regarding that matter, the truth of the matter is this isn't news. I mean, it is news, it sucks, but at the end of the day, there's not much we can do about it, and the future is going to be pretty bleak. If the Amazon thing takes off, you can start counting on your LGSs on closing their doors if they specifically only deal with Magic. Now, the ones I know of, or participate in going to, they have been outsourcing to other areas. Some of them getting into Games Workshop and bringing in miniatures, you know, X-Wing, Attack Wing, and all the tabletop games. Not only is it more profitable for them, but it's more stable. They get more people coming out. Yeah, and Magic is just too up in the air. I mean, in Canada specifically, we have a 10% tariff on all sealed products now, on top of, you know, everything. So, you know, when I talked to Wizards of the Coast customer line, they were like, basically, oh, it's whatever, you live in Canada, right? That's your local problem, that's not our problem. But they don't seem to understand that this is actually a bigger problem. If the tariffs extended to other countries, say Australia, UK, China, Japan, and it 10%. 10% is more than enough to affect a bottom line. And where it goes from here is it only goes down. I mean, you can't keep a game thriving in just one country. This is a more of a multicultural, multi-country game at this point. Yeah, so what is it going? So let's take a look at what it states here. There's a bunch of good posts I've seen regarding this. Earlier today, but basically it's you know, it's shutting down the doors for LGSs, and you can't play these games on Amazon. You can't go to Amazon's headquarters and play. right? It just, it doesn't make any sense. I mean, it's like going to Walmart to buy packs and then sitting in the McDonald's at Walmart trying to play the game and getting kicked out. I mean, in when I was down in Victoria, we had this thing where, you know, Thursday night was game night at Tim Hortons, and it increased sales because the Tim Hortons was, you know, dead at that time of night. So we would show up at like 7 p.m. and we'd play until midnight, you know, and bolster sales. And we had a gentleman who would show up and play Scrabble, you know, every Thursday, and he was off on the side. A bunch of high school kids would come out and play Scrabble with him, and we played Magic, and some people played Pokemon. It's like, you know, these are, it's an isolated circumstance, right? There was no centralized game store at that point, and most of the game stores would close down at 10 o'clock. So this was an option at one, you know, one time a week where everyone could just move from one of the game store, multiple game stores, and converge at the local Tim Hortons and play Magic. But yeah, so this basically, you know, while TCG, you know, the Amazon issue isn't similar to the TCG player issue. TCG player is online, but they are a marketplace for local game stores. Amazon is not. Amazon is purely out for profits. Amazon is under fire for the way they treat their customers, and now WoTC is branding themselves with that. So not only do they have bad customer service relations, they now have bad employee relations, which, you know, it's neither here nor there. And I'm sure they're trying. I mean, at the end of the day, you got to think of this from a business perspective. They want to make their money. They want to deliver a game, do their job, per se, and make their money. But if they're not making the money, then their job suffers. But if their job is suffering to begin with, or if they're not delivering the product, then it affects the money. It's a vicious circle, or a vicious cycle, and nobody really wants to address the pink elephant in the room, but they need to get their shit together. Because after this, if this fails, they're going to start, you're going to start seeing cuts again into card quality. I haven't had any issues with card quality where I am. I don't understand, maybe cutting, like the way the sheets are cut for some cards, ink issues. I have a stack of misprints from Dominaria of like every third or every second common slot in every other pack was lightly toned. But, you know, I don't have any curling issues. But this is the thing. They'll start making cuts again, right, to try and save the money. And when they can't make the cuts, it'll move into more serious things like job firings, a reorganization of management, Hasbro selling it off, like they did with multiple other games. And at the end of the day, they'll probably make a jump into online. And once that happens, then it's done. This isn't something that's new. You can literally, anyone with any logic can sit down and look at how it's going to turn up at the end. I mean, some YouTubers are quite intelligent and know how to generate a lot of revenue on YouTube without having a business model. But if you look from a actual storefront business or a business like Wizards of the Coast, you have to be able to look down the line. And in order to do that, you have to sit down, think about the repercussions of what's going to happen. If I do this, this is going to happen. If I do this, this is going to happen. They haven't been making all the best choices of late. So that's pretty much everything I have to say about this. Thanks for watching.
I'm Jade, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Round Table, Crusader of the Wasteland. If you've liked this video, hit subscribe, click like, and ring the bell. If you'd like to donate, links are in the description. Remember, just by liking this video goes a long way, and donations are always appreciated, but never required. Thank you for watching, and come again soon.